So, the title of this slide is a guide to, or set of slides, or this discussion is a guide to philosophical writing. Okay, so I was able to make these slides last February 13 pa in preparation for this discussion. No, kay even if I have read these references, I have to read it again. Sa dami ba naman ang binabasa ko? Other than preparing for the courses in philosophy, I also prepare for my other research endeavors. And kaya nga ako nilagay dito na para mag-handle sa course dito is because I am really active in research, especially philosophy. So for the introduction, as usual, this is a lecture whose aim is still to describe philosophy's nature. We're still there. Although marami na tayong nabasa, but we're still in that SLO, okay? Concerning research, and is based on the book of Elijah Chudnov entitled A Guide to Philosophical Writing, okay? In this text, Chudnov would say, dalawa lang. No, dalawa lang ang sa mga kurso tulad ng Introduction to Philosophical Research. Dalawa lang ang main aim or purpose. It's either okay, it focuses on the process of philosophical writing or the product of philosophical writing. So, if I were to ask you, saan favorable si Chudnov dyan? Ha? Eventually. But meron siyang disclaimer. Napansin nyo dyan sa kanyang introduction. Let us see. We want to know how to make something that looks the product of philosophical writing. Iyan ang gusto nating malaman. The product. Kasi especially in our society, we're very much output-driven. Tama? So in other words, how it looks, it's not really what the product is, but how, okay, how to make something that looks the product of philosophical writing. Kasi hindi naman perfect yung kanyang advices dito. Okay? Ano lang yung itsura? Okay? Ano yung itsura to make something that looks the product of philosophical writing. So that's why I place it there because that's very important. So in other words, it is wiser or more practical to focus on the process. Pero yun nga, ang dilemma natin dito is philosophical writing is distinctive because of what? Of the character of bits of philosophical writing. Meaning to say, different types of writings that philosophers did, like the dialogues of Plato. What else? The critiques of Kant. The treatises of Locke. The magnum opus of Heidegger. Iba't iba kasi yung mga produktong yan. Iba't iba yung mga itsura. Okay? Usually, most of us start with no idea or a positively harmful idea of what philosophical writing is all about. We're only given with primary references. Magyun na, even in other courses, di ba? Unsa may ipabasa sa inyo, ha? Primary reference. Diretso. Pero wala pa mo gitudluan unsay how these philosophers came out with these types of writing. Diba? So most of us, again, start out with no idea or a positively harmful idea, di ba, of what philosophical writing is all about. Now, for Chudnov, the aim of this guide, of the book, of the whole book, ang pasabot niya, is to develop a good idea of what philosophical paper should look like. So you will not be writing dialogues like that of the dialogues of Plato or say the magnum opus of kuratan ka? Aminin mo naglinog. Magnum opus of Heidegger. But in the academic context tayo, meaning to say, okay, philosophical paper. Okay? So, the aim of this book is to develop a good idea of what a philosophical paper should look like. In other words, essay or thesis. May maumaginin yung buhaton sa fourth year. You will write papers or thesis, di ba, as what we all know, and defend a focused thesis by developing an extended piece of reasoning in favor of it. So in other words, the thesis, ang pinakamit talaga ng thesis is the argument. Right?
Oh.
So now, in this guide, in this book of Chudnov, which is how many pages? 60 pages. No? Has, would say that of the five features that characterize every philosophical paper or thesis, and these are the following. Purpose, or the why. Audience, or the people who you'll find or who will find it interesting and beneficial, your paper, your thesis. In other words, relevance of the study. Unang relevant. Sa science, manggod lahi, manggod ang... Pero somehow, makita po ninyo ang relationship. Iba kasi yung format sa science. Iba yung format sa philosophy. Pero you will see some common denominator as we go on. Argumentation. So this would be the bits of reasoning that serve the purpose. In other words, the logic of your paper. Kaya nga required na pumasa kayo sa logic bago kayo mag-take nitong kursong ito. And then, narrative. Narrative, according to Chudnov, is the global structure into which arguments are arranged. So that's why you have the title, you have the subtitle, you have the sections, you have the paragraphs, you have the sentences, and the ideas. In other words, yan yung itsura ng inyong, or in other words, format. Right? And then, style. Diba? In other words, the manner in which the paper is written. Lahi ang style ni Plato. Dialogue form. Diba? Lahi ang style ni Kant. Critic. Critic is self-reflection man. Diba? Isa pa man. Si Locke, lahi. Because gina-engage niya ang society. Yan na yung style. Si Heidegger, lahi. Self-reflection po. And at the same time, engaging society. Ana iyang style. Unsa kaya inyong style? But of course, that needs time for you to develop. But in the meantime, kaniya itong buhaton. Diba? Kani ganing book ni Chudnov is very advanced. Okay, it already teaches you what to anticipate in a paper or in a thesis. Diba? Oh. Although we are still under SLO1, which is to discuss philosophy's nature, we need to have an idea of how a philosophy paper at this point or thesis looks like. So ito yung mga sinasabi niya. Now for our discussion, that's just the introduction. For our discussion, the general aim of every philosophy according to Chudnov or philosophy paper is to defend a thesis by setting out reasons in favor of it. So, thesis, reasons. In favor of the thesis. I-defend nyo yung thesis. Now, a topic is not a thesis. It's different. It is a broad area of concern. So, that's why when you're asked, kinsa man imong philosopher, did I ask you to have your philosopher na?
Oh.
Unsa man nga area of concern ana nga philosopher, sugdi na po na ninyo pili. Kay broad man kay ang gina-discuss sa philosopher. Okay? So daghan man siyang works, lailahi pag gina sila, maglailahi bi ang view sa philosopher pod kung inyo i-observe ang mga works niya. Now, it's a broad area of concern. A thesis is something that can be formulated in a declarative sentence. Kung sa logic pa, what do you call this? It's called the proposition. Can you still remember what a proposition is? A proposition is a declarative statement. It is a statement of fact. Of course, naana siya parts. The subject term, and then the predicate term, the copula. Pero, here, in the context of writing a paper, when we say thesis, it's in the form of a declarative sentence, it's a proposition. Because you propose something na kayo gina put forward. Now, defending a thesis is to develop some line of defense for a claim. Okay? Na kayo gina claim. By giving reasons for thinking it is true. Because as a declarative statement, it is a statement of fact, it must be true. And you defend that. Okay? Stiff neck ko. Stiff neck. Now, a thesis should be as focused as you can defend it adequately in the space given to you. In other words, pag fourth year ninyo, naaman mo yung thesis 1, thesis 2. Diba? So, kana lang inyong time. So, pumili kayo ng philosopher, area of concern, be specific in such a way na matatapos nyo siya within 2 semesters. You get that? For example, of a thesis. Isang example ng isang thesis. You could argue that even if there are some biographies, a time traveler could not have, example ni Chadnok, like one in which a time traveler kills his grandfather, that does not mean time travel is in general impossible. So that is the thesis. Okay, that's an example. Naana siya yung discussion si Chadnok dito sa libro. Itong taas, good. Ako lang siyang gi-shorten dire. That's the example of a thesis. In other words, kita pa lang ninyo dire the very concept of time and time travel. Kinsa kaya na nga philosopher? Naaba? Pwede yan siya sa philosophy of science. Philosophy of mind. So a thesis is precise enough so that it is clear what counts as an adequate defense and what counts as an adequate refutation of it. Because when you make a thesis, you do not just defend, you also provide counterexamples as if you assume na the criticisms of to your thesis. For example, the claim that Hume's skepticism about induction and common sense, kailan mo ni Hume, do not pick out specific things about which we can tell whether they are in conflict or not, and to develop this to a more precise one, then what do? To examine the premises he uses in arguing for skepticism about induction. So in other words, kada nga thesis, which is Hume's skepticism about induction and common sense, do not pick out about specific things, is not precise. So how do you make it precise? Kana. To examine the premises he uses in arguing for skepticism about induction. Okay? And then, one important concern in purpose is to be specific. Nag-ingon ganit na diri, di ba? Dapat precise siya. Di ba? Okay? So we go on to specific aims. Because kung ingon mong ka dire nga discussion, that is general. We go to specific. You have to be specific. Because of the time constraints that you have, right? So one important concern is to develop a more specific idea of what sort of things you might aim to do in a philosophical paper. Or what sort of thesis you might defend. So be specific. There are many types of papers. Okay? And Chudnov would discuss this as the explain and evaluative papers. And naa siya yung mga examples. Kita ninyo itong mga gi-quote niya nga naka-gray ang color sa... Those are the different types of explain and evaluate papers and other types. Now, what do you mean by this? A key sort of accomplishment you will often aim to achieve in the papers you write is to explain and evaluate arguments given in the works you are studying. Example, siyempre, mabasa magyun mo. Hindi magyun mo makasulat kung wala mo yung ibasa. Basic. Anong gagawin nyo sa binasa nyo? I-ano nyo siya? I-explain nyo siya. At least to yourself. And evaluate it. Kaya gamitan man ninyo siya sa inyong paper. Get that? So, given in the works you are studying. For example, imong philosopher si... Wala pa kay philosopher? Machiavelli. What work is Machiavelli known for? The Prince. Correct. It's a short philosophical work. Sa social political philosophy, ginagamit yan siya. Now, what are you going to do? You have to read that. Read it. Explain it. Evaluate it. Unsa yung argument. That's what you do. Philosopher? David Hume. What work is David Hume known for? Katong nag-discuss about causality. Unsa itong work? Kana si Hume very much known for the cause and effect concept. So here you focus on an individual philosopher's particular argument for a specific claim by explaining and evaluating. For example, Mr. McFaith is a philosopher, for example lang. And ang iyahang thesis in the work that you have read is or would go this way. We cannot contribute to determining what the future will be like. Example, that's the thesis. That's the claim. And then the claims he appeals to in support, in other words, yung reasons or arguments, naa siya. Okay, like the premise, one of them would be, every proposition is either true or false. Okay, and then naa siya gitawag na argument type. Ang argument type muna ang yung structure sa yung argument. Ang iyang argument type would be the argument type or support McFaith intends his premises to lend to his conclusion. So, example ani, which later on we will discuss. Sa book, ginadiscuss po ni, na specific section katong sa argumentation. Gidiscuss po ni diri sa purpose. But ano lang siya, pahapyaw. Example would be deductive. What is a deductive argument again, class? If you've been into logic? A reasoning from general to? So, ang iyang type is funnel type. Funnel type ba? General, specific. Ang example, Ana, is kanang Aristotelian syllogism. Remember mo? The categorical syllogism. Remember mo? The rules that you have memorized, remember mo na? So muna ang deductive argument. And then, naapoy isa, the inference to the best explanation. And naapod, inductive arguments, abductive arguments, and so many others. Now, the explain and evaluate paper differs in the evaluation part. Or what you want to say about the argument given in the work you are examining. For example, you might agree with the thesis and defend the argument for it against someone else's criticism of it. For example, kana imong ginabuhat sa imong paper. That could be one. And there are many other examples. Ha? Another would be to agree with the thesis but criticize the argument for it. You might criticize one or more of the premises. In this case, you should try to say what premises you prefer and why. Napoy isa dire. Muna siyang explain and evaluate paper. Ako pasabot. Pero ang akong gigamit ng example dire sa kuang PowerPoint is kani. Kani siya. O, nara siya dire sa kong PowerPoint. Okay? Agree with the thesis and defend the argument for it against someone else's criticism of it. Muna pinaka-basic. Agree with the thesis and defend the argument for it against someone else's criticism of it. Muna traditional na ginabuhat sa mga philosophy students. That's why muna akong gibutang diha sa akong slide. Okay? Pinakadali. Tanawa lang gutong uban. Diba? Lisod. Lisod siya, pero kung kasabot gid ka sa imuhang ibasa, dali na lang. Pero ang akong suggestion sa inyo, ha, practically, when you go to thesis, be practical. I'm not also saying na kana nga type yung pilion. Pwede nyo explore itong uban. Sige lang, kay papilion tamo ana after midterms. Buhat mo mong sariling thesis. Buhat mo mong thesis. Dili ni sa thesis course, ha? Pero magbuhat na mo. Kaya muna ako ipasubmit sa inyo dito sa thesis 1. Pag-abot ninyo yung fourth year. I-keep na ninyo sa inyong database, ha? Muna inyo i-work out. Sugod pa lang second year. Ikaw, third year naman ka. Buhatan na ninyo. Now, do not confuse, explain, and evaluate papers with exegetical papers or exploratory papers. Kasi ang point ng exegetical papers or interpretative, okay, papers is to defend the thesis about the meaning of some writer's work. Diba? Sometimes, there are those who write about this particular philosopher and another writes about this particular philosopher. Asa man sila nag-argue sa interpretation. So if you want to engage in that, it's called an exegetical paper. Can that be a thesis? Yes, pwede po. But lahi ang explain and evaluate papers. Okay? Oh. Dako'y kailaan ni, ako ang classmate, ang iyang gibuhat is exegetical. Meaning to say, gi-explain niya ang meaning sa ginaingon sa philosopher. Kinsa man itong philosopher? Si Kant. Kadawag na mo critic. Critic of judgment. Third critic niya, muto yung gi-interpret. Against other interpretations. Muna yan thesis. Exegetical na siya. Pero usually, most thesis are explain and evaluate type. So, do not confuse these two, ha? So, explain and evaluate papers contain an evaluative part unlike in the exegetical or interpretative class. Okay? Na-evaluative part ang explain and evaluate. Sa exegetical, explain lang. Meaning. Pero, pwede po sa may imong thesis. Pero dire, evaluate. What do you evaluate? The argument. Okay? But in explain and evaluative papers, such as for example agree with the thesis and defend the argument for it against someone else's criticism of it, nagagamit pong kag exegetical skills ana. Dili man kay porke explain in evaluative paper, dili ka naga interpret. Ga-interpret gyapon ka. Kailangan gyapon imong exegetical skills. But you will also have to work out your understanding of the relevant issues surrounding the argument. And use this understanding as well as the different alternative understandings and explanations of other philosophers of the relevant issues in the literature to frame, or approximate the argument you are explaining. Kay mubuhat man ka og theoretical framework. Muna ang gitawag na theoretical framework. Did you get that? Kailangan ni mo i-work out imong understanding ba sa explain and evaluative paper. You have to, kay naga-defend mga thesis sa isa ka philosopher. Okay? Or, pero, naga-explain ka sa argument sa philosopher para i-defend ang imuhang thesis. Wala akong pasabot ba? Pero, you have to compare that argument with the arguments of other philosophers who have the same concern. Did you get that? Okay? Other philosophers of the relevant issues in the literature to frame, approximate the argument you are explaining. So, nana dayon kay theoretical framework. Another term for this is your lens. What's your lens? So, in other words, dili gid diay nga kung naana kay philosopher, that's the end of it. No. You also have to find other philosophers who have similar, somehow seeming to be having the same type of arguments and compare so that you could properly construct your own or defend your own thesis, your claims, or argument in the paper. Ayaw mong kalimutan na ha? Sige lang, kayo naman po yung YouTube. Pwede naman ninyo balik-balikan. Pag abot ninyong fourth year, balikan sa nakotong among sa ni sir. May balik ko dito sa channel ni sir. O, kana, inyong buhat. Ito muna yung purpose na to. No? Okay. Now, there are ang types of aims. Kaning aims? Unsa ganining aims? Unsa ang imuhang buhaton sa imong paper? Ha? Ang example na ko again sa specific aim is katong ganiha. Kani o? Agree with the thesis and defend the argument for it against someone else's criticism of it. And there are many other examples sa kay Chadno ba? Oh. So, kani sila tanan, assuming that you have read the others, they have three things in common. Number one, in each, there are one or more pre-existing theses you consider. Kaduha, in each, there are pre-existing arguments that you analyze. And katulo, each you take a definite stand on the thesis and arguments you consider. So aims will influence aspects of your paper like its structure, argumentation, but in practice, you think of your aims one way, then as you write, you realize that it is best to think about them in another way. In other words, magbag-o na po ang imuhang aim. Magbuhat kag draft, pansin ni mo, wala pa man mo kabuhat, good, magbuhat na mo ana. Pansin ni mo, magsulat ka, muna mong aim, no? Ingani ang structure sa iyong paper. In other words, mag-defend ka og argument ni philosopher A. Di ba? Tingala ka, pagsulat ni mo, magbag-o na po ang imong aim. That's reality. If I may simplify this, kana bitong magsulat ka, magbag-o na po imong isip. muna ako pasabot ani. That's what I mean here. As you write, you realize that it is best to think about them in another way. Muna yung pasabot. Now, in your final version, your introduction, I am talking about introduction pala. Diba, yung paper, namagin lang siya introduction, muna akong pasabot. That's what I'm talking about. In your final paper or version of your introduction, your introduction should make your purpose crystal clear to your reader and in your paper. Importante ginang introduction. It should always be obvious how each part of your paper serves the purpose you articulate in the introduction. So, unsa gani ang pwede nato mahimong purpose? Specifically, for example, balik ko dire. For example, your purpose is to agree with the thesis and defend the argument for it against someone else's criticism of it. For example, muna imong buhaton sa imong paper. Muna ipasabot nato sa aim. Asa ni muna isulat? Sa introduction. So the introduction should have the part where you motivate your project. What is another term for motivation? Your significance of the study class. Sa introduction gyapon na siya kita. Which comes toward the beginning, sa sugod, and says something that will make your reader know whether your thesis is true or not. The introduction should have a part where you supply what else? Aside from the motivation, the background. Muli siyang gitawag sa other disciplines as background of the study. Sa introduction niya makita ha. For understanding your thesis and ensure that your reader will understand what your thesis means. It includes definition of terms. Sa asa gapon na siya makita? Introduction. So the introduction should have the part where you state your thesis. Asa dapat makita? Sa beginning or sa end? Sa end, sa introduction. And flag it with prefixes like, I will argue that, or what I will try to show in this paper is that, muna yung end sa inyong introduction. Okay? So, unsa gayud ito'y sulod sa introduction? Kung di mo mutan-aw dire, sa inyo lang may, unsa gayud ito? Op. Dili. Sa to? Motivation. Background. Sa pa? Ha? Definition of terms. Klaro, definition of terms. Katulo. Statement of the problem. Oh, kabalo-kabalo na mo gamay, ha? Ako magunong gituyo og discuss kay layo pa magutong topic na ano? Atong paper. Gusto na ako magbasa sa taog something that we could somehow allow ourselves to imagine ba unsay itsura sa paper ba? Kaya ang topic na paper gyud is actually napa dito after midterms. Pero ako lang giuna kay para naapon may something to anticipate already. So that's why I'm using Chadnok here. Para na may advance ba nga, inga na de itsura sa paper. Di ba? So if your reader does not know your thesis and does not find it intelligible or masabtan and interesting by the end of your introduction, then your introduction has failed. Wala, di na siya interesado sa imong paper. Kay later on maginana class, ang practical gyud ani is kana inyong thesis pag kumana mo ana, i-publish man gud ninyo para na ipulos. Kay gusto mo ginato na i-publish kay alang nga naman diha lang na magstay sa shelves, sa library. Pero inyo nang choice. Sample, gusto nimo i-publish ning kay Marcus Aurelius because sa tanaw nimo it has something a lot to say about the contemporary politics in the Philippines. For example, i-relate nimo siya sa authoritarianism or populism. Pwede na. Para ang inyong thesis, wala lang siya dito sa library. Naa siya dito, gibasa sa tanang tao. Ay relevance. Para makahimo mo og relevance sa society board as philosophers. Mo man ay relevance na ito, class. Dili ra man ingon nga maguna-una rata dito sa kaamulang grounds, mag-philosophize, dili oi. We have to make it practical in our time right now. We have to get it published. So, asa na magsugod? Introduction. Kay, ang introduction mga class, mura siya complete. Dili po siya abstract. Ang abstract mga good, gamay na mga abstract, 200 words sa mga good siya. Ang introduction is, it's like a structure of the paper already. Actually, nag-struggle po ko, ana, sa kuang doktoral na una. Okay, nag-struggle po ko, ana, sa una, and then I realized na, ah, yan ni day. Even sa mga papers na na-publish, nag-struggle po ko, ana, kay, so, careful po mo, kay, sa ubang journals, nailay po sila og format. But we will go there. But here is the thesis. Diba? Sa introduction, kita sa last part. Now, introductions are relatively short. In meeting the demands of motivating, stating, and supplying background for understanding your thesis in a concise and perspicuous manner, as simple as possible. Pero it is difficult. It takes time to be able to master that. Kung pwede pa lang, you write 5 or 6 theses. But that's not going to happen because you're going to just write one thesis in your time as a philosophy student. Tama? Pero kung pwede lang ba, para ma-master niyo mo magbuhat ang introduction, buhat mo, 5 ka thesis o unum. Pero that's the challenge. How to make a good introduction in your thesis when you reach 4th year? And go through the pains of making a good introduction. Pwede naman magsugod-sugod. Since na-discuss naman na ito, kinsa man yung philosopher, pangitaang area of concern, try to start doing, coming up with your own thesis statements na. Gusto lang ako magsugod o ano-ana? Check. When do you write the introduction? Ha? It is written... Naroon, nadira. It is written. Difficult makaya siya isulat. When is it written? Most of the time. It is written last. Sir, gusto mo na, sir? Libog makaya na yung pasabot. Di man ko bot pasabot nga written last, kidya. Kasi, mag-change pa mag-guna. It's written last or at least after writing a rough draft of your first paper, then you write your introduction. Pero sa kuha po ng experience, I write, of course, the introduction. Pero I'm not saying it's final. So to tell you class, kanina ko ang doctoral, nagsulat ko, daghang kig introduction akong gisulat. Magpabag-ubag-o siya. Kay along the way, I am reading man. Okay ra na siya. Okay ra na siya. That's natural. But you have to write your introduction. But do not be surprised that later on you will change it. Okay? Written last or at least after writing a rough draft of your paper first. Ayun la. Give me instructions sa bigger classroom. Bye-bye. Bait, tabangin ko ba? Isa-isa kayo, basin. Very good, bro.